You're not blaming me, are you? Being married to a prison officer didn't lose the contract for you, I'm sure of that. But maybe your dishonesty was the problem. Perhaps the Liefenbeckers felt they couldn't trust you.
I don't see any point in analysing why the Liefenbeckers decided against me, but I do know this. I am a successful businessman. Now, Meg, it may sound ridiculous to you, but if a businessman is a success, his wife doesn't need to work. And she certainly doesn't need to do a job that most people wouldn't touch with a barge pole. Now, part of my business life has to be socialising, and you have to be part of that. Now, being a prison officer, it's not going to work.
Is that an ultimatum?
Yes, Meg. I'm sorry. It is.
Hurry up and eat that. This will get cold.
Well, where's yours?
Not having any, I'm due at work.
Well, you shouldn't have gone to all this trouble then.
Well, I didn't want you saying I was failing in my wifely duties again.
I didn't say that.
No. You said I was ruining your business, which is worse.
I was upset about losing the contract. I'm sorry, okay?
No, it's not okay. Just because things go wrong for you doesn't mean to say you have to take it out on me.
Look, it wasn't entirely my fault, Meg. If it hadn't been for your job, I wouldn't have lost the contract in the first place.
You lost it because you told lies.
Hal would still have recognized you.
Yes, but it doesn't mean to say he would have cancelled the contract. There's nothing wrong with being a prison officer.
No? Well, you don't see too many of them at the Victoria Club, I can tell you that.
It's nice to know your husband's ashamed of you.
Meg, I'm not ashamed of you.
Oh, we'd been through all this before we were married.
We have. We're both saying things we don't mean. Look, I'm sorry, business pressures get to me.
Do you think I haven't got any pressures?
Well, I know you haven't. I wish you hadn't.
All we seem to do is lock the women up, release them, and then wait for them to be sent back in again. It's hopeless.
Then don't do it.
Well, what am I supposed to do?
If you want to help them, do something useful like social work.
Oh, I haven't got the qualifications.
Well, what qualifications do you need?
Well, I'd have to go back to university.
Well, that's fine.
Yes, you'd like that, wouldn't you? Do you think you could cope with a university student for a wife?
Meg, I could cope with anything as long as it made you happy. The trouble is, neither of us are happy with the present situation. Now, you've already resigned once. Why don't you go back to university? Oh, lots of people are doing it.
I'm too old to be starting school again.
Oh, nonsense.
I want to take years. I want to do something now.
Well, isn't there some job you can do that doesn't need qualifications?
Oh, I don't know. Oh, look, I haven't time to discuss it now. Eat your breakfast, it'll get cold.
Well, okay, then we'll discuss it tonight.
See you later.
Now, where the devil did you get to, Lizzie?
I went to see my old mate, Sid. He was too sick to see me, so I went to see him.
And did you see him?
No, he wasn't at the home. He was visiting relatives, and that's when I got lost.
You mean drunk, don't you?
I went to the hotel to ask for directions.
So you didn't find Sid. Where did you spend the night?
At the home. They gave me a lovely, soft, comfy bed, not like the lumpy thing we got here.
Did the people at the nursing home know who you were?
No. And you're not going to have them up for aiding and abetting. They was lovely to me.
If nobody helped you, how did you get to the home?
On the bus.
Where did you get the fare?
From the woman in the op shop.
Ah, the woman who gave you the clothes.
Yeah.
And she didn't know who you were either.
Of course not.
Obtaining goods and money by false pretenses.
I told her I didn't have any money and I didn't.
Listen, Birdsworth. You don't know how much trouble you're in. Escaping lawful custody, obtaining goods and money by false pretenses, theft.
What theft?
The woman's handbag.
I never stole that, I borrowed it.
You stole it. How much money did the woman in the op shop give you?
$2.
You wouldn't have got to the country on that. Where did you get the rest of the money?
I put the money on a horse.
With an SP bookie?
On the TAB.
Ah, which means you wouldn't have been able to collect till the end of the day. You're out in the country by then. Where did you get the money?
I forget.
Perhaps a spell in solitary would improve your memory.
You can't put me in solitary and I don't even have to speak to you.
What do you say to that, Miss Bennett?
I think you're wasting your time. Haven't you heard the latest? We don't punish escapees at Wentworth anymore. We make the place so nice they don't want to leave us.
So there.
Come in. Oh, hello, Meg. You're a bit early for the meeting.
Yes, I wanted a word with you first.
Oh, what about?
Getting another job. Well, the truth is, Bob isn't very happy about me working as a prison officer. It's the long hours, the shift work. Well, he feels... Well, we both feel we'd be happier if I was doing something less regimented. Social work, perhaps.
Would you be willing to go back to university?
Well, no, not really. I was thinking more of a welfare officer. Parole and probation? Or something still in the department. I was wondering if you knew what my chances were of getting a job like that.
Well, I don't know. I'm not sure. Well, I'll make some inquiries and let you know.
Thank you.
Come in.
Hello, Meg. Given the ideas much thought since yesterday?
Ideas?
The conjugal rights, the visiting scheme.
There isn't any such scheme yet.
Well, there's nothing to stop it now that Lizzie's back.
I would have thought that was every reason to stop it. Women walking in and out of this place when they feel like it. She practically laughed in our face when she was questioned about it.
Could we please get this meeting started properly? I've told the minister about the new scheme when he phoned to see what I was doing about the escapes, and he seemed to like the idea.
Well, of course he would. It'll make him sound good when he announces it in Parliament.
Yes, until something goes wrong, and then we're the ones who have to bear the brunt. Mm.
If anyone bears the brunt, as you put it, Miss Bennet, it will be me. The scheme stays. All we have to do now is to work out the practical details. I've been in touch with the Ararat prison, who already have a scheme similar to this. It seems that an indoor and outdoor visiting area screened from the rest of the prison is essential. Now, I suggest we use the shed where the garden tools are kept. We could easily put a retaining fence around it.
There'll be a lot of jokes floating about when people find out that the women are meeting their husbands in the garden shed.
I'm not interested in jokes. Mrs. Morris, you seem to be the only one who's not actively opposed to this scheme. Could you arrange to have the shed emptied and redecorated?
Right. How much do we have to spend?
None at all. The women will have to do everything themselves.
They're not going to like that.
Too bad. If they want this scheme, they're going to have to work for it.
Precisely, but we'll have to be very careful. The women are always suspicious of a scheme that originates from us.
Well, perhaps if I spoke to them, I'm sort of the man in the middle. It'll sound less official coming from me.
Yes, very well. I'll leave it to you and Mrs. Morris. Now, what's next on the agenda?
Could you get the women together for me, please?
Oh, yes, of course. As soon as they finish work for the morning.
This is ridiculous. We should call a union meeting.
No, we can't afford to block this with the minister making a statement in Parliament and make us look bad. Our public image is bad enough already.
Well, something must be done. This place is turning into a...
Into a brothel? I wouldn't worry about it, Vera. I think we can safely leave this to the women to mess it up like they have every other scheme.
Forget it.
What do you mean, forget it?
Why should we bust a gut setting this thing up?
Because you're the ones whose husbands will be visiting you.
I haven't got a husband.
Well, that's only because you shot him.
Oh, shut up.
Yeah, well, I won't see Kevin either. We're divorced now.
Well, some of you must have husbands who'll visit you.
Well, what about de factos? Do they count?
I'm not sure.
Yes, as long as you can prove the de facto relationship.
Well, I can prove it, all right. We've got two kids.
Mm. Hey, what about getting our kids back in here?
Yes, as long as child welfare agree.
And there'll be no more censoring of the male?
Oh, well, I'll give you a hand fixing up the shed if it means I can get Elizabeth back.
What's wrong with you? You can only have Elizabeth back if the child welfare say so. And we can only have unsupervised visits and uncensored mail if we're good little girls. Can't you see it's just another way of keeping us in line?
I don't understand you, Bea. I thought you liked the idea.
Not like this, I don't. It's got to be the same for everyone. Now, I've got a bloke and he isn't even allowed inside the gates.
Well, I can't help that. If people don't stick to the rules...
Well, that's it then, isn't it? If you think I'm going to help this lot get their blokes in here into bed, when I can't even talk to mine, you've got to be out of your head.
Well, I reckon she's a bloody selfish cow.
Will you shut up? Can't you see that Bea's fighting for the principal?
Oh, bleeding principal. She's just jealous, that's all.
Yeah, look, why should we miss out? Just because Bea can't have her bloke in here.
It's not like that.
Oh, yeah, you'd understand, wouldn't you? A bull dyke whose girlfriend's bloody dead anyway. I mean, you'd really miss having a bloke in here, wouldn't you?
Shut up, Chrissy.
Well, she's right. Why should we miss out?
Why shouldn't you? I've got to.
Well, that's not my fault, is it? It's not my fault he's divorcing you.
It wasn't my fault either.
Well, whose fault is it then?
I said shut up, Chrissy. It isn't anyone's fault. It's the system. You'll get your bloke in here when we get what we want. They'll give in.
You reckon they really will give in, Bea?
You heard what Andrew said. It's being announced in Parliament. They can't go back on it now. We've got to screw them for all we can when we've got the chance.
And what if it doesn't work?
It'll work. Davidson can't afford another disaster.
Well, I just don't see what Bea Smith's up to.
Well, I would have thought it was perfectly obvious. What isn't obvious is how we handle it.
Well, Vera did tell me something. Why was this Ken Pierce banned?
He was caught in a store cupboard with B. Smith.
Yes, I remember now.
It's not funny, Mr. Andrews. That sort of thing is very bad for discipline.
Well, it's not too far removed from what we're suggesting now, is it? Why not lift the ban on Ken Pierce? If you give some of them visiting rights and not the others, the scheme will look like it's just another way of keeping them in line.
Well, that's precisely what it is. Well, don't look so shocked. The women have to learn that if they behave, they'll be rewarded. That's how society works. We have to teach them that. It's called rehabilitation.
Well, you paint a pretty sordid picture of it.
But an accurate one. What we have to decide is whether to allow Ken Pierce to visit or not.
Well, you know what I think. Lift the ban.
Yes, it probably would be quicker that way. But he's got to be restricted to interview room visits only, no contact visits. If Smith objects, I don't think the rest of the women will support her.
And if they do, you can ban their visiting rights. Is that what you're getting at?
Precisely. I want to talk to them before they go to lunch.
We could fix that shed up ourselves, you know. We don't need B. Smith's help.
No, but you know what she'd do if that happens. I don't fancy getting thumped.
She can't thump all of us, can she? Anyway, a lot of women want that scheme to work.
Well, I think we should wait and see what the screws do.
Oh, yeah? What if they don't give in?
I don't know.
Well, I do. If I can't get Elizabeth back in here because of her, I'm gonna...
Attention, everybody. Switch the television off, please. I understand Mr. Andrews has explained the new schemes we are implementing.
Has he told you what we thought?
Quiet, Smith, until I've finished. As I was saying, what Mr. Andrews may not have made clear is the importance of these schemes, not only to you, but also to the men and women in other prisons who may have the same opportunities if our scheme works. Participating in these schemes is a privilege. Now, some of you may think you have no privileges to lose. So in order to be perfectly fair, I'm lifting all existing bans on visitors. Of course, only husbands and de factos will be allowed private visits. The rest will be restricted to visits in the interview room and garden, as before. Now, are there any questions? You were saying something, Smith.
I was just going to volunteer to help decorate the shed, Mrs. Davidson.
I'm sure that would be perfectly in order.
I'm glad I won't be using it.
Pick up a few old girlfriends, couldn't it?
Oh, come on, girls.
Sorry, Mrs. M.
Not exactly the Windsor Hotel, is it?
Depends what
you're
on.
Yeah.
Oh, poo. What's in here? What a bloody mess.
Well, you can always make it presentable with a bit of work. You can't expect to have everything laid on, you know.
Well, there's not much room for furniture.
All you need's a double bed.
Mm. All the furniture will be coming from inside the prison, so there'll be no double beds.
Well, we could use that divan that used to be in the nursery.
Yes, you probably could. Bea, could you organise the women, please? You'll have to get all this stuff and move it back into the main storeroom. And then I want a couple of women to help the men put up the fence.
Yeah, OK. Christy and Hazel, you can give a hand with the fence.
Oh. Why us?
Because I said so.
I'll leave it to you to arrange it amongst yourselves.
Well, go on.
What can I do, Bea?
Well, it's a matter of using your special talents, Lizzie. We need to acquire a few things to make this place livable. You can get with it, Jude.
Oh, no, I can carry some things.
Not with your tiggy account. Dorian and I'll do the heavy work. There'll be enough heart strain in this place later on.
Come on, love. Let's see what we can find.
Okay, right? Nimble fingers.
Okay, let's get at it.
Well, I can't see why we're working so hard to make this place look good. We won't have anybody visiting us here.
Oh, I don't know. With all these visits and the unscented mail and the women getting their kids in here, we should get something out of it, even if it isn't exactly what the screws had in mind. Come on, start taking this up outside.
Oh,
sorry. Oh, yuck. You know, I'm almost glad I haven't got anyone to visit me in here.
This'll look smart, huh?
Beauty. I'll take this, eh?
Yeah, great. Oh, needs a bit of water, huh?
How is everything?
Marvellous. It's amazing what they can achieve when they want to.
Yeah, that's it. A bit higher up on the left. That's good. That's great. Good. Oh, g'day, Mr. Davidson.
Smith. Oh, you have done well. Certainly didn't take long. Oh, that's a nice table lamp. It's just like the one I have in my office.
Yeah, just something like that.
Yes, amazing resemblance. Well, looks as though we're ready to have our first visitor. Would you inform anyone who's interested they can make application after the morning roll call tomorrow?
Okay.
Well, carry on.
Bloody Lizzie, you almost ruined everything. Pinching Mrs. Davidson's lamp, really?
Well, I had to because there wasn't anything else.
Could I have a word with you, Mrs. Morris?
Yes, of course.
I've spoken to the department, and they do run a course for welfare officers. Usually it takes 3 months, but with your university credits and your experience in here, you should get away with about a week's familiarization course.
Does that mean they'd accept me?
Well, I haven't asked them specifically, but with the difficulty they have in finding suitable people, I'm sure you won't have any trouble.
That's terrific.
I'm not so sure.
Well, how do you mean? Oh, means you'll have to find a replacement for me. Look, I won't leave until you have.
Well, it's not that, although that will be difficult enough. I'm not sure that you are taking this job for the right reasons. You know what the women are like, and if they suspect for 1 minute that you're taking this job to spend more time with Bob, then they'll make your life hell.
Well, they're not exactly making it heaven for me now.
No, but if you're running away, welfare work is not the answer. Think about it anyway.
Thanks. What's all this?
Oh, I just thought we'd have a quiet dinner at home.
Meg, don't you think you're carrying this thing a bit far? I mean, I apologize this morning. I know you're a perfect wife. You don't have to prove it.
I like that. Go to all this trouble and this is all the thanks I get.
Well, I don't want you knocking yourself about. I know how hard you work at the prison all day.
Maybe not for much longer.
What do you mean?
I took your advice. Asked about a job in social work. Apparently, they'd be overjoyed to have me.
Meg, that's marvelous.
Now, just a minute. It may not happen. Erica thinks I shouldn't take the job.
Well, of course, she'd say that. She doesn't want to lose you.
She thinks it might be harder than the one I'm already doing.
Will you be wearing a uniform?
No.
Or will you be involved in riots?
No.
Locking people up?
No.
Carrying guns?
No, of course not.
Then it can't be harder, can it?
Then you think I should apply? I take it that means yes?
Mm. Yes.
I want to make an application for a conjugal visit, please, miss.
Name?
Hazel Kent.
I know your name. I want to know the name of the visitor.
Oh, George. George Goscombe.
Why's the name Kent?
We're not married. He's my de facto.
I hope you can prove that.
We've got 2 kids. Is that good enough?
Then why aren't you married? You know what that makes the children, don't you?
That's none of your bloody business.
Any insolence, Kent, and you won't get any sort of visitor.
Sorry, Miss Bennett.
That's better. I'll fill that out and bring it straight back. Oh, Latham, well, who have you been living with?
Nobody. I want to apply to get Elizabeth back.
That scheme hasn't been approved yet.
Well, I want my application ready for when it is.
You've left a space where it says father's name.
Elizabeth ain't got a father.
Yes, Birdsworth?
I want to see Sid.
You sure he wants to see you?
I want an application form, please, Miss Bennett. Oh, good morning, Mrs. M.
Good morning, Lizzie. Lovely day?
Yeah.
What's this?
Well, it's my application for the parole and probation job.
Oh, that will have to go through the department. Not through me.
But it will need your approval, so I thought you'd like to read it first and then pass it on.
Well, if you think that's the right thing.
Yes, I do. I took your advice and I've thought about it very carefully. I'm not looking for a soft option. If I were, I could just retire. Bob would be only too pleased to support me. I just think I could do more good trying to keep these women out of prison.
Well, I hope you're right, Meg. I really do. It'll certainly help to take some of the strain off us here.
Well, perhaps there won't be so much of a strain if some of these new schemes work.
Well, they'll have to work, Meg. Otherwise, I'll be looking for a new job, too.
Fletcher, I went all the trouble of filling in that application form and he tore it up and said, I've had all the visits I'm going to have for a while.
Well, what did you expect? I told you these visits were only for good little girls.
Oh, it makes me sick. All I wanted was somewhere for Sid to lie down when he got here.
Yeah, that's why Hazel applied, isn't it?
Don't be so filthy. I was just thinking of Sid's delicate condition.
Well, Lizzie, at your age, you couldn't think of much else, could you?
Do you only think from the waist
down? All right, ladies, come on, settle down. As you know, Mrs. Davidson's keen to get these conjugal visits started as soon as possible. The first visitor will be here tomorrow. It'll be yours, Kent.
Oh, that's too nice.
Good on you, love.
Now, as you know, you're being used as a sort of guinea pig, Kent. This will be a trial visit only, so any attempt to escape, smuggle contraband, anything at all, and this visit will be the last one. Not only for you, but for everybody else. You understand?
Well, I know there are people who'd love to stop these visits, Mr. Fletcher, but I'm not going to give them the chance.
As long as you understand. You've got a visitor, Latham.
Who?
Somebody called Michael O'Brien.
Can't you touch him?
It'll be in the interview room. Come on, Latham.
What the bloody hell are you doing here?
I came to see you.
About bloody time, isn't it?
Yeah, well, I couldn't come before, you know that.
Well, you could have bloody written.
Just sit down, Latham, and watch the language, eh?
I couldn't write. I don't want to draw attention to myself.
No, you never want to draw attention to yourself, do you? Afraid of your own shadow, you are. All you think about's yourself.
Yeah, well, I'm here now, aren't I?
Yeah. I can't think why.
I heard about the kid.
It's not a kid, it's a little girl, Elizabeth.
Elizabeth. She's in a home now, isn't she?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, that's why I'm here. I've got a job now. Things are going pretty good. And you're going to be out on parole soon. Well, I'd like to look after you both. You and Elizabeth.
Honest?
Honest. You know, and... Well, if things work out, maybe we could get married, you know? The whole thing.
Well, why didn't you say all this before?
Well, you didn't give me a chance.
Oh, I don't mean just now. I mean, you know, before.
Yeah, well, I was hardly in a position to, was I?
No. Suppose not. Hey, look, are you sure about all of this? I mean, it's been a long time.
Of course I'm sure. I haven't thought about anything else. Which home have they got Elizabeth in?
Kingston.
Do you reckon I could go and see her?
You're still nervous, aren't you?
Even more so. Do you reckon I could see her?
I don't see why not.
Does she look like you?
Sort of. Oh, she's prettier. She's got my hair, though.
Mrs. Davidson, I'd like to see Latham when you're finished.
Right.
When do you think you're going to see her, then?
This afternoon, if they'll let me.
Your boyfriend must be a patient man.
How do you mean?
Well, you've been in here how long now? It must be, what, 4 years? Took a long time for him to come and visit you.
Yeah, he used to come and visit me in Barnhurst, though, didn't he?
Yeah, but not in here.
Oh, it's too far to come, wasn't it?
Oh, come in, Latham. Close the door, please, Mr. Fletcher. I think you'd better sit down, Latham. I have some rather bad news for you.
Is it about my parole?
No. The Child Welfare Department have just been on the phone to me. They feel that in view of the violence that has taken place in Wentworth recently, bashings, riots, and even murders, it would not be a suitable place for a small child. I'm afraid your application to have Elizabeth returned to you has been refused.
Hey, cheer up, Chrissy. Now, they're probably right. This isn't the best place to bring up a kid.
Oh, yeah. You'd know, wouldn't you? I mean, you're likely to have loads of kids.
Well, I got kids, and I wouldn't want them in here. I wouldn't want them to see how we're treated.
No, we know what you want, and you're getting it, so you can shut up.
Will you listen to her? When Bea had the visiting scheme stopped, you called her a selfish cow, and now who's being selfish?
And who asked you?
Oh, why don't the lot of you shut up? Okay, so Chris is a selfish bitch. Well, we've always known that. But that doesn't give them the right to take her kid away from her. And you can stop taking it out on everyone. You're almost due for parole anyway.
But they've already turned me down twice.
And the way you're carrying on, they'll turn you down forever.
Well, isn't that what they want? Keep Elizabeth in a home. Another one for the system. You all know what happens to kids in homes. Half of them end up in here. But they already know I'm a crimson. What sort of a chance has she got?
None of us want to see Elizabeth in a home. I mean, I love her just as much as you do.
No. No, you don't. Nobody loves Elizabeth more than I do. Those bastards are not going to take her away from me. I'm going to get her back if it's the last thing I do.
Well, if she does anything stupid, they'll cancel the scheme.
Yeah, well, maybe that isn't such a bad idea. Now, the trouble with these things is, the more some of us get, the more the rest of us realise how much we're missing out on.
I understand you're in charge of the first conjugal visit, Vera.
So I understand.
Has the procedure been explained to you yet?
Not exactly. It's like everything else Mrs. Davidson takes up, rushed into without any thought.
Yes, well, it shouldn't be too difficult. The main idea is to keep these visits as unsupervised as much as possible.
I know what the idea is. I just don't see why we're allowing these visits in the first place. We should have refused to cooperate.
Well, it won't last that long. The scheme's already falling apart. Latham's complaining because she can't have a baby with her. Smith's making ultimatums. Just let it die a natural death. That way we can't be accused of anything. This must be him. George Goscombe?
Yeah, that's right.
If you'd sign the visitor's book first, please.
Right.
What are those children doing here?
They're Hazel's kids. Mine and Hazel's.
Well, you can't bring children in on a visit like this.
But that was the whole idea, so the family could spend some time together. The governor phoned me personally.
Yes, that's right. You realise, of course, because these visits will be unsupervised, special security precautions will have to be taken. Miss Kent will have to be body searched,
yeah.
Both be...
Okay. I don't think the kids want to hear that.
Yes, right. Well, if you follow me, I'll take you to the visiting area.
Right.
Going to see your mum, eh, kids?
Yeah.
If you get Miss Kent, please, Miss Bennett. Follow me.
Good day.
Good day. Just remember, if any of you try and leave this compound without permission, there'll be trouble. Understand?
Yes. She's a rotten bitch.
Well, how's my kids? Oh, you got big. Let's have a look at you.
Yeah, Mum.
Is that a bruise in your face, love?
Yeah. I had a fight with the kid at school. Dad had to go and see the headmaster.
Ah, oh, some little bugger called you a jailbird. Johnny was right to hit him.
I gave him a blood nose, didn't I, Dad? And he was older than me.
You shouldn't fight, Johnny. And you shouldn't encourage him.
He's got to learn to stand up for himself, Hayes. Can't have people calling your names.
Has this happened before?
Johnny's always fighting.
Oh, shut up. Johnny, stop it. Why didn't you tell me about this, George?
It's not the sort of thing you can discuss with a screw looking over your shoulder.
Well, we can talk in private now. That's one good thing about these meetings.
We'll have to move when I get out of here. Get Johnny into a school where nobody knows I've been inside.
Living costs money, Hayes. Bond, electricity, gas.
Yeah, we can't have Johnny fighting all the time.
Okay, love, we'll manage it somehow.
Here, look what the women made for you.
Is it mine?
Yeah, you can take it home. Got the other end. I'll throw it to you.
You don't throw it, Mum. You bowl it.
Yeah, all right, I'll bowl it to you.
Okay, I'm ready.
Hey!
Oh, she's hopeless, Mum.
She's only small. Let her have the bat and you bowl, eh? Oh, go on.
Okay.
Don't bowl too hard.
No.
Tired already?
They're okay on their own. They play pretty well together.
Had to, I suppose.
Yeah, well.
I made this.
Yeah?
Yep.
Well, don't worry, love. You're still a good cook.
Aw. It's not that bad.
There's a divan inside.
Oh, yeah?
Be more comfortable.
Well, we go inside?
Wouldn't mind.
Oh, sorry.
Kids, you behave yourselves, all right? Me and Mum are going inside for a while.
Okay.
You're not leaving those children out here on their own?
Well, they'll be all right. There's nowhere for them to go.
I suppose you want me to babysit for you.
Could I have a word with you, please, Miss Bennett?
Yes, Mr. Fletcher.
The kids will be right there, Mr. Goscombe. What are you trying to do, Miss Bennett? Embarrass those people?
What's it matter? They're only criminals.
Not in front of the kids.
I don't see what you're so upset about. You're as much against this scheme as I am.
That's not the point. You don't embarrass people in front of their kids. Now lock up here and report back to reception. There's plenty of work to do. Well, go on.
Well, you still want to go inside?
I feel funny now. Seen your wife lately?
Yeah.
How is she?
Much the same. I don't reckon she'll ever be coming out now, though.
No chance of a divorce, then?
Oh, I can't divorce her, not now, Hayes. She's not the full quid. Doesn't even know what's going on anymore.
Well, it wouldn't matter to her then if you did divorce
her. No, I can't, Hayes. I'm sorry. I can't.
Sorry. I know it upsets you talking about
it. No, it's not that. It's a bitch of a screw. She's really ruined the whole visit.
Yeah, I know. Mr. Fletcher was nice, though.
Hmm.
Funny. I suppose he knows what it's like. He used to have a wife and kids of his own.
He's divorced, is he?
No. They got blown up by some madman. He must have seen the case. It was in all the papers.
Oh, yeah. God. Makes you realise how lucky we are, doesn't it?
Yep. Lots worse off than us. The women are real jealous. I'm the first one to get one of these visits.
Hey, Jude, see if you can find some antiseptic cream, will you?
Yeah, sure.
How the hell did you manage that anyhow?
I was just thinking about something else.
Yeah, I bet I know what it was and all. Hazel out there with her bloke.
Oh, God, there are some women on the outside who have blokes all the time, you know?
Yeah, but this is different, isn't it?
If it upsets you so much, why don't you write to Kevin? Maybe with this new visiting setup, you'll be able to sort things out.
Oh, no. It's too late. The divorce is almost through. I'm never going to get to use that bloody shed.
There's no use getting upset about it, Vera.
Upset? What do you expect? You should have heard the way he spoke to me. Just ordered me out of the garden. You would have thought I was the prisoner, not Kent.
Well, these meetings are supposed to be private. How would you feel with someone watching over you all the time?
I'm hardly likely to be in that position, am I?
No, you're not.
I meant I'm not a prisoner.
So did I, Vera.
I should have expected you to side with him. I've just heard you applied for the job as probation and parole officer.
Who told you?
The whole prison knows. Mrs. Davidson has to have her letters typed. It doesn't take long for the word to get around.
Well, I suppose you would have all found out about it sooner or later if I get the job.
I just don't understand why you applied for it. I would have thought you had more sense.
Well, what's wrong with it?
I may be able to do more good for the women than I am now.
You'll never do them any good by pandering to them.
Suppressing them hasn't done them much good, has it?
Meg, Kent's visiting time's up. I'll escort Goscombe and the kids to the main gate. Perhaps you'd like to get Kent?
Yes, of course.
Here she comes.
Hey!
All right, everybody. That's enough. Back to work, Hazel. Same goes for the rest of you. May, will you come with me, please?
Oh,
how was it?
Oh, you know, great. So he hasn't lost his enthusiasm, then?
It wasn't like that.
Oh, go on.
Well, it wasn't. We had the kids there.
So what? You could go inside, couldn't you?
Oh, Vera was hanging around, making us feel uncomfortable. Even when Fletch told her to shove off, we still felt, you know...
Bloody Vera. She'd ruin anything.
What? If Fletcher told her to shove off, I don't see what the trouble was.
Oh, not all like you, Chrissy.
What do you mean? I'm just like the rest of you. Oh, come on. You were all thinking about it. Well, Doreen even stuck her hand under the sewing machine because she couldn't get her mind off it.
Yeah, but that's the trouble, you see. I mean, you're out there and everybody knows you're out there. Makes you feel real funny, as if you're in a glass cage or something.
Well, it sounds to me as if the scheme's a bit of a waste of time.
Oh, no. Still really cute, seeing the kids and everything. They've grown.
How come they let the kids in?
Well, why not? They're my kids.
Yeah, but, well, you and George, you're not married, are you?
Well, George is their father. You don't have to be married to have a family. Johnny's been filing at school. God, he's a tough little bugger. I suppose he'd have to be, with everybody knowing I'm inside. When I get out, we're going to move into a different school. I should see Barbara. God, she's grown up. She's a real little lady. She looks like a little angel. Oh, they're beautiful kids.
Nice kids Hazel's got.
I don't think you and I and Vera's very good books at the moment.
Well, I know what I've done. But why is she so upset with you?
Well, I've applied for a job as a probation and parole officer.
Yes, I heard. I must say, I could do with a bit of a change myself.
Well, why don't you take one?
Me? What would I do?
Well, you could do something in the youth services, couldn't you? I mean, you love kids. You could run a boys' club or something.
No, I think it'd bring back too many memories.
Of course.
No, I think I'm stuck with the prison service. I wish you luck, though. You know how some of the officers feel about social workers.
I know, but I don't understand why. I mean, we're all trying to do the same job, aren't we? Rehabilitate the women.
No, most of the officers here seem to think that they're here to make sure that they're punished.
Well, I've never seen my job like that.
No? Well, you're probably better off doing social work, then.
What are you doing here, Latham?
I want to apply for a conjugal visit. Yeah. And I want Elizabeth to come too.
Oh, yes? Who's the lucky man?
Mick O'Brien.
Oh, come off it, Latham. These visits are for husbands and de factos. What rights he got to a conjugal visit?
He's got every right. He's Elizabeth's father.
And what did Fletch actually say to Vera when he told her to shove off?
Well, he told her we were supposed to have privacy, see? And when she wouldn't leave, he yelled at her.
But you mean in front of you and George?
Oh, no, they're on the other side of the fence, but we could hear him.
It's not like Fletch to stand up for us.
Ah, here it is. He's always had a soft spot for kids.
Yeah, well, we all know why that is, don't we? Come on, about time we go back to work.
Oh, fair go, Bea. If we can't have a visit, at least we can hear about it.
Well, Bea's got nothing to worry about. She'll be having a visit from Ken pretty soon, eh?
A visit? I'd be lucky if I didn't hear from him.
Well, why not, if they said he could visit you?
We've only got their word for that.
Well, why don't you write and ask him? I mean, they said that our letters aren't going to be censored anymore. You can write what you like.
And what if they are still censoring the mail?
Well, that's a good way of finding out, isn't it?
Yeah, I might do that.
Where the hell have you been? You've been bobbing in and out of here all day. There is some work to be done, you know.
I've been applying for a conjugal visit.
Conjugal.
And they're letting Elizabeth in, too.
Come off it.
It's true. Her dad's bringing her in.
Wouldn't they have to find out who he was first?
They know who he is. I told them. It's Mick O'Brien, that bloke that came to see me yesterday.
Wasn't he at Barnhurst?
Yeah.
Well, what is he, a screw or what?
Of course he's not a screw. I wouldn't sleep with one of them bastards.
But you reckoned you didn't know who the father was.
Yeah, well, I just said that so I didn't get into trouble. Look, it wasn't really like I said. I couldn't get a bloke whenever I wanted. I had to be real careful.
Well, that's terrific, isn't it? I mean, there you were sleeping with him at Barnhurst, and you reckon they're going to bring him in here to let you do the same thing?
Why not? He's asked me to marry him.
Oh, you kid.
Well, if they let him in, B, you've got to apply to see Ken, because if she can get away with it, anybody can.
Yeah, well, she hasn't got it yet, and she isn't likely to.
Well, I have got it, see? And I'll tell you something else you don't know. Mrs. Morris has resigned. She's going to be a social worker.
Do you think Latham will get a visit?
No, I don't think so. But that's the trouble with these schemes. How do you decide?
I don't see why you're so against it, Jim. I mean, take Hazel, for example. She's absolutely terrified she'll lose her visiting rights. So there's no way she'd cause trouble in the next month.
No, she won't. But what about the others? If you give one something, they all want it. And then when they're refused, it causes resentment.
Yes, but you've got to start somewhere. Besides, if she does get a visit, it'll make Vera's day.
Oh, yeah, she's in a filthy mood, isn't she? The trouble with that woman, she can't bear to see anybody having a good time.
And nothing much on the telly lately.
No, it's been a bit miserable, isn't it? Still, it doesn't make that much difference when you're in here all the time.
Anyone like another cup?
Oh, no, thank you.
No, thanks, Vera. I'm right.
It's funny Latham admitting who the father of the child was after all this time.
Yeah, she was hinting it was a prison officer when we first found out she was pregnant. That woman would say anything to make trouble.
I suppose she thinks it was so long ago, it doesn't really matter.
Mm. Hello, staff room. Just a minute, please. It's Mick O'Brien in reception asking to visit Chrissy Latham.
He had a visit yesterday.
Well, actually, I arranged for another visit. Meg, if you'll tell Latham she's got another visitor, I'll supervise it.
Chrissy, a visitor for you.
Another one?
The same one. He's been allowed another visit in the interview room.
See, I told you they'd let him in.
Come along, I haven't got all day. You're not entitled to this, you know.
Hey, Mrs. Morris. Is it true you're going to be a parole officer?
No, I've only applied for the job. Can't get rid of me that easily.
That's what some of the women are worried about. We might never get rid of you.
And what's that supposed to mean?
Well, you're a screw, aren't you? You're a good screw, but a screw all the same. And when the women get out of here, they want a screw looking after them.
If I get the job, I won't be a screw, as you call it. I'll be a parole officer.
Not to us, you won't. You're one of them, and that's never going to change.
Well, it's nice to know I've got your support, B.
I'm just telling you, that's all.
Then you don't think I should apply?
If you're asking my opinion, no, I don't.
Well, you'll be interested to know that Miss Bennett holds exactly the same opinion. Leif,
thank you.
How come you're back in here?
Miss Bennett gave me special permission.
Well, get on with it, Latham. I'm sure you've got a lot to talk about.
Yeah.
I went to see Elizabeth this afternoon. Gee, she's a beautiful little kid. Just like a mum. I wanted to take her for a walk, but they wouldn't let me.
Oh, no, they wouldn't, would they? Well, you might have been anyone wandering in. You could have pinched her.
Yeah. It'd be easier if my name was on a birth certificate. Do you reckon you could fix that up?
Yeah, of course.
I mean, without the screws finding out.
They already know you're the father.
Yeah?
Well, I told them.
Well, you shouldn't have done that.
I had to. Here, anyway, they got these new kind of visits in here. Conjugals. It means you can come in and bring Elizabeth with you.
You mean private visits?
Yeah. They've got this shed out in the grounds, and it's got all this grass around it so Elizabeth can play on it.
How long's this been going on?
They had the first visit today. One of the women had her bloke in and her two kids. They're not married, but he's the father of the two kids, you know, just like us.
Yeah, well, they're hardly going to let me bring Elizabeth in, are they? I mean, they wouldn't even let me take her out of the home.
Oh, I can arrange all that. It's just a matter of signing the right papers, that's all.
How long will that take?
Don't know. All them things take a long time, don't they? Still, be worth waiting for, won't it?
Yeah. It's a funny bloody prison. Private visits, screws letting me in twice a week. I wouldn't mind being in here myself.
I wouldn't mind that either.
Things haven't become that easy, Latham. Still, I suppose it's only a matter of time.
Well, it's not likely, is it?
Well, we wouldn't have so many escapes.
No. Be trying to break into the place, not out of it.
Enjoy the visit, Latham?
Oh, yeah. Thanks ever so much for letting him back in, Miss Bennett.
It's the least I could do. You won't be seeing him again for a while.
What do you mean?
We checked your story about him being Elizabeth's father.
Well, he is.
Oh, yes, we know that now. I just received a telephone call from the department. They confirmed that he was at Barnhurst while you were there.
Well, so what? He's done his time. He's free now.
He's an ex-criminal, Latham. You know the rules. No consorting. I'm sure when I tell Mrs. Davidson the news, you won't be getting a visit from him or your child for as long as you're at Wentworth.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun arrives.